we have two brakes on the bike. First of all, you need the rear brake because for the rules. Because in case something happens, not, let's say, normal riding, front brake is missing, then it's something as emergency, let's say, rear brake. But rear brake becomes more and more important in the latest days riding a motorcycle.
For sure, when you brake with the rear brake, the balance of the bike is different because you can maybe the rear stays a bit more on the ground and it's helpful for braking. But also for turning sometimes it's helpful because when you touch the rear brake, the bike turns a little bit more. And even in acceleration, sometimes if it's getting some wheelie, with the rear brake you can keep the bike lower.
Sometimes it's not enough the front brake to stop the bike. So you need also the rear brake to use some more the rear back torque to reduce the speed of the bike. And also we are using rear brake to control the setting of the bike, let's say the position of the bike while riding.
We use it on the right foot normally. Also in the past it was only on the right foot, but now with all the developments of the bikes, now we are also using on the hand, and yeah, it's also helping a lot.
We discovered that using thumb brakes is important to control the stability of the bike. First of all, because of thumb brakes is not powerful, let's say, as a feet, but it's more regular how you apply the force, so it's more stable. A rear foot brake is affected by the bumps and the movement of the bike, so the pressure is not stable. By hand, it's very, very much more stable.
Sometimes I put my leg out for the balance of the braking, and in that point, I'm not using the rear brake. So thanks to the thumb rear brake, I am able also to use it. Normally, yeah, I combine the two. Maybe in the same corner, I try to combine rear brake with the foot and also with the thumb. Here's Misano. I'm gonna tell you some parts where I touch the rear brake. Here we arrive in corner number 4. You can see my hand that is touching the thumb brake, because when I put the leg out, I need some help in that moment. Yeah, look here. You can see a little bit. Just on corner 4 because of the position, you can see my thumb that is touching the thumb brake. Now we arrive into corner 7. Here also, I touch a lot with the foot. It's difficult to make the perfect pressure because it's a bit irregular, as I told you, but it's important to stop the bike. Here we arrive into corner 12. Is a really fast corner. And here I touch it also with the, even if it's right, with the foot. Here sometimes when there are some bumps with the right foot, maybe you also move the foot because of the bumps, and then the bike becomes a bit unstable.
Bike's moving all the time, so applying the force on the rear brake, yes, the rear end of the bike becomes more stable, let's say. But of course, it's the way how much you push, because it could be some collateral effect, you know, side effect. And sometimes if you push too much, you can even upset the bike and get it more nervous and more movement. Many years ago, I remember Mick Doohan introduced, because he cannot use the right foot because he was injured. But honestly, in the MotoGP, it appears to be useful, let's say, last 10 years, more and more. Because it's the way also how riding style, there is evolution, the riding style.
In the past, not every rider used the rear brake. Also, for my side, I didn't use it in the past. But after my big injury in Germany in 2017, I had to put the foot in a different way. So then I tried, and I actually liked, and then from then, I saw that using the rear brake is much better for everything, so it's really important for be fast. You have to understand very well the balance between the front and the rear brake. It's not easy, but at the end, with all the experience and all the years, I am trying to learn these kind of things.